My name is Mark Mason. I'm from Queens, New York. I'm the Chief Financial Officer for Citi. When I started here at Howard, I was not in the School of Business. I actually joined Howard as a physician's assistant major in the School of Allied Health, and that lasted for about 4 weeks. And then I switched over to the School of Business as an accounting major and then ultimately became a finance major. I highlight that because Howard, as you know, has the broadest offering that it can academically for its students. And it gave me the opportunity to kind of be a little bit more thoughtful about what I wanted to study and to switch over into the School of Business, which was a much better fit, despite my grandmother's pressure for me to become a doctor. Both of my grandfathers were businessmen. One was a carpenter, one was a landscaper. And so that sense of business, the business acumen, those things were things that I was naturally drawn to. And so when I got to Howard and learned a little bit more about the School of Business, it seemed like a natural fit. I've been on the board for, I think it's 12 years now, and I've held a number of different positions on the board, from chair of the investment committee to the compensation committee, which I lead now. I co-chair or co-vice chair of the board with Leslie Hale, and obviously the chair is Dr. Morse, Dr. Larry Morse. Phenomenal team, and we have a phenomenal board that I think has come together. Founders is one of my favorite places. I was talking to my daughter earlier today, who is a junior here. We were both kind of reflecting on how significant Founders is and what's special about it, aside from the rich histories that's there and it being a significant or historical building, is that you can both study there and look out onto the yard and really take in all that is Howard. It is a special building, it's a special place for me, and I'm sure a special place for many of the students that have come here over the years. You know, what drives my service is Howard's done a tremendous amount for me. Everything from allowing me to develop the skills, hone the talent that I thought I had to offer, prepare me for the world to go out and compete. So Howard is foundational to who I've become. And it's kind of, when you come back to Howard, it's like coming home, right? And so the idea of service to Howard is akin to the idea of service to my family, right? And that's what drives me. And look, the mission is pure in terms of what I want for this institution. We want an institution that can not only rely on its legacy, but continue to enhance and strengthen that legacy. And that's what serving's about. It's ensuring that we protect all that is good around Howard, and we continue to build and ensure that it sustains itself going forward. It's probably one of the most memorable parts of my experience as serving as a trustee. Vernon was a mentor of mine and for many years. But the experience that's most memorable is when Vernon decided to serve as the chair of our search committee for the president, not the sitting president, but the prior president, Dr. Frederick. And, you know, he just has an amazing ability to bring people together around a common goal, vision, mission, and to foster, you know, active debate and dialogue, but ultimately to bring people to a common decision and understanding. And he does so with the command of the room, with deep knowledge of the history, an amazing recollection of events, and his whole aura is a representation of the excellence that Howard is. And to watch that, to witness that, to be a part of that, through that search process was an amazing experience for me. Howard's a special place, as I mentioned earlier, and it's done a tremendous amount of good for me. And there's a sense of indebtedness that I feel to Alma Mater for sure.